unbelievable.
You can hear John Hanel's frustration.
$120.
In his cell phone video he recorded, minutes after, he says he paid a tow truck company $120 in cash to drop his van.
Never coming here again.
I'm getting them on video.
Hanel stopped at this Taco Bell in downtown Bloomington to grab food. He says he saw a food truck next to the lot, so he went over to check it out, but it wasn't open yet.
There's a curb there I was standing on, and by the time I turned around, my car's hooked up. I'm like, you can't tow my car, man. I've never left the parking lot. I'm standing right here. I'm telling you I'm going to Taco Bell.
What was I supposed to do?
Christy Byers says she parked in the same lot and left the property to run an errand next door before she bought lunch.
No more than 7 minutes later, my car was gone.
She did end up buying food, but her decision to leave the lot cost her big time.
You're not to go across the street to the ATM machine, pull out $200, and I'll take you to your vehicle. I just wasn't thinking at the time. I wanted my car back. I wanted to get back to work.
We asked Taco Bell and the tow truck company operating here about this. They pointed out that there is a sign in the parking lot that says customer parking only. If you leave the property, take your car with you. We will assume it's been abandoned if it's unattended. A spokesperson with Taco Bell Corporate said in part, our guests frequently tell us they can't find a place to park due to the number of non-Taco Bell customers who inappropriately park in the lot. Our franchisee has no contractual or financial relationship with any towing company, but they asked that the tow truck driver verify whether the guests are in the restaurant before towing a car. Both Byers and Hanel spoke to Bloomington police after their ordeals, and they're not the only ones.
So coincident with...
I found out the Bloomington City Council has been drafting an ordinance that would regulate private towing.
We've been talking about for probably 2 years.
Councilor Andy Ruff told me he had a draft ready. Then the state legislature passed a new law. It went into effect this summer.
It's not as simple as, you know, X plus Y equals Z.
I asked Bloomington attorney Brian Drummy to take a look at that law. He told me it does appear to make what happened to Hanel and Byers legal.
So as far as you can tell, that's...
As far as I can tell, it is legal for them to watch the lot and tow the vehicle as soon as they make the determination that someone is parked there or that doesn't have permission to park there.
But Drummy did point out two parts of the law you should know about. The first revolves around signs like this one, which must say who is allowed to park in the lot and who to call if you get towed. Councilor Ruff told me Bloomington's ordinance will likely include extra requirements, like having a sign at every entrance to a lot. Same goes for payments. Ruff said he would like to lay out exactly how much money a towing company can charge.
Mirrors the city-initiated tow fees. Mm-hmm. And we think that's defensible to the state if it's ever questioned as being reasonable.
The city caps towing fees at $125. That's less than the $200 Byers says she paid.
My car was still on there.
As for Hanel's situation, where he says he was charged before his van was actually towed away, that's a tougher call, according to Drummy.
Although the intent, I'm sure, was to solve problems, it may not.
The law says a company can charge you to drop your car, no more than half of the amount of the fee the towing company normally charges, but it doesn't define a reasonable fee.
What my concern as a lawyer would be, and especially if I wear my cynical lawyer hat, is that the tow truck companies could inflate their charges so that they can continue to charge whatever they're charging now.
The total was $240.
Drummy's second piece of advice when it comes to the law, make sure you get a receipt. The law requires a towing company to give you one that shows what they normally charge for a tow and how much you pay. Hanel says he didn't get that.
I asked him for a receipt. He said, I don't have anything. I said, just write it on a piece of paper. He goes, no.
Hanel's next step could be to file a complaint with the Indiana Attorney General. He probably wouldn't be alone. His parking in Bloomington remains at a premium.
$120.
And parking in the wrong place doesn't come cheap.
Unbelievable.
Fast cash, I guess.
It's easy money for them.
Parking garages, we hear it all the time. It's about as common as hearing about IU basketball.
The owner of the company that towed both drivers refused comment through an attorney. The Bloomington City Council is expected to introduce that private towing ordinance in January. We'll keep you updated. For CBS 4 Problem Solvers, I'm Jill Glavan.
Jill, thank you. Hoosiers